evaluate function and an expression. When replacing a variable, we always use parentheses. And then what is inside of the function replaces the variable. So let's take a look at example one. Here we're going to take our 8x squared and plug it into our x. So that means we're going to get the square root of 2 times 8x squared plus 3 times 8x squared. Watch how long you draw your bar for your radical. You want to make sure that it only goes with the stuff that's supposed to be inside the radical and that you're actually covering that. So now I have 2 times 8 inside my radical, which should give me 16x squared, and then 3 times 8, which would give me 24x squared. Here we can simplify what's inside the radical by taking the square root of 16, which would give me 4. Square root of x squared would give me x. And then we would just still have the 24x squared. No like terms, and we're done. Going to example two, here we have a binomial that we're going to replace into our function. So you want to keep in mind that because we have a square, that we would probably want to know this formula. A minus b quantity squared is equal to a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. Or if you prefer, you could do foiling, which means you're going to distribute your a through and your b through. N minus 3 squared minus 2 times n minus 3 plus 5. I'm going to use my formula here because it's the fastest way to get through this. So squaring my first term, I get n squared. To get my middle term, I take n times 3 times 2, which is going to give me a negative 6n. Squaring my last term, I get plus 9. Now we distribute our negative 2 through, and that gives us a negative 2n plus 6 plus 5. Now I need to combine all my like terms. I have 2n terms, and I've got 3 constants. So we have n squared. Negative 6n and a negative 2n is going to give me a negative 8n. 9 plus 6 would give me 15, plus 5 will give me 20, so I'm going to have a plus 20. And I'm done.